Here we are now in Best of Breed, and they've all assembled. We should have our 12 specials plus our veteran class winners, and then of course winner's dog and winner's bitch down here at the end, and there they are. And we should have 12, 7 dogs and 5 bitches. Let's move our camera down here from right to left, from bitches to dogs, as our judge is backing up towards the camera now. And there they are, our Best of Breed class for 2014. I think the bitches and our class winners, winners dog and bitch, are now against the ringsides, and the dogs are going to come around, our dog specials. And they're leaving the ring. So we might be doing the girls first, if that's the way they were brought in. Or maybe they're just going underneath the big top over there, the tented area. Now just the bitches, I think, are coming around. But I saw the judge indicate that as I peeked around the viewfinder. Looks like number 25. If it is, it's Red Devil's Irish, Lucifer's Fire. Joseph Philip and Matthew Mattus are the owners and the breeders. Kelly Marsh is also a co-breeder. Gonna go around one more time. You might have heard that. This could be it. Let's see. Everyone's back in place now. Let's see if we get some sorting. Okay, I think we see what's happening here with the winner's bitch coming out. Take them all around was the order. Let's see if we get some pointing. Yep, that's what he's doing. There's the balance of the class. Congratulations to one and all.
How you like them apples, Matt?
Our Best of Breed today goes to Red Devil's Irish, Lucifer's Fire, RN. The owner is Joseph Philip and Matthew Mattus. The breeders, Joseph Philip, Matthew Mattus, and Kelly Marsh. And this particular entry, our best of breed, went on to win a Group 4. So big congrats to Red Devil's Irish, Lucifer's Fire. Best of winners goes to Sugar Bush's Made in America from the Open Dog class. The owners, Thomas and Dana Miller. Our best of winners also received an Award of Merit. Best of Opposite Sex, champion Irvin Hill, Leave It to Me. Owners, Anthony Barker and Thea Lotti. Select Dog, grand champion Rockledge McCollin of Meath. Owners are Linda Honey and Joyce Wilson. Select Bitch goes to grand champion Donna Dare's Emerald of Erin. Peter Shaw and Marilyn Shaw are the owners. And I think there are two more Award of Merits down there in addition to our Best of Winners. One is to grand champion Leahy's Lad of Redlock. The owners are Ed Nagel and Rochelle Nagel. And another one goes to grand champion Sharab's Commander-in-Chief. The owners are Sharon Lundgren and Robert Lundgren.
Today is the October the 5th, and we are at the National Specialty Show for the Irish Terrier Club of America. And my name is Ron Ho. I'm the Vice President and Acting President of the Irish Terrier Club of America, as well as an Irish Terrier breeder and exhibitor. We're here with Clay Cody, who is the breed judge today of our Irish Terriers. Clay, I want to ask you first, if I could, a little bit about your background, particularly in terriers, and both as an exhibitor and as a judge.
Well, I've shown terriers for 50 years. I've shown a lot of Irish. I've won best in shows at these shows. Well, with a Welsh, not an Irish. I've won several groups at the Garden with different breeds.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah. Anything else?
No, that's okay. I've shown. I had a very successful handling career.
That was my understanding. Okay. We had an entry of about 49 today. Well, can you give us a general impression of that entry?
Well, first of all, I didn't see any bad mouths. Most of them, almost all of them, were in very good condition. Okay. What impressed me more than anything when I originally started showing this, there was a huge problem with tail sets. There was a huge problem with subcutaneous skulls. You didn't see that. Matter of fact, you saw some really beautiful heads. Dogs that gave you great looks. And I was impressed.
Okay.
Very happy.
What did you particularly like about the best in breed dog who you picked?
I loved his head.
Okay.
I loved his size. He's dead sound. And I thought he was the most complete dog that I had.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And was there a particular group that you found impressive among the opens or the champions in terms of maybe one of the sexes?
I like my winner's bitch class. I had three very nice bitches in there. Mm-hmm. I really did like those.
Okay.
That's where the quality is.
All right.
More quality.
Anything else you can tell us as breeders and exhibitors of how we can do better in terms of breeding our dogs and showing our dogs?
I think the breed's in good shape.
Okay.
It's definitely better than it was. It's right. Come a long way in their fronts, even though they can use some help in their fronts. You see some little too restricted. Restricted coming at you and restricted going away from you,
right.
Or going around.
Mm-hmm.
Rears are all pretty good. You didn't see any really bad rears.
Right.
You saw some really good ones. Only saw a couple bad tail sets, and I'm big on that because
right.
You really do need a complete picture, and that tail set just happens to be part of their balance. And I always place dogs when they're moving. You know, I spent many, many years making them look good standing still, but there's not a lot you can do with them moving, so I just feel that is the ultimate test.
Okay.
Is they have to make the same picture moving as they do standing. So
those are great comments. Thank you so much for being of service as our judge. And
thank you very much for asking me. I really enjoyed
it. Thank you for the interview as well,
yes,
sir.
Yes.
Good to see you.
Okay.
Take care.
All right.